So in the previous topic, we had concluded that DNA is more stable and preferred for the storage of genetic information, and RNA is preferred for transmission of genetic information. But by discussing all this, the question which arises is which is the first genetic material? Okay, so to get the answer of this question, we are to see what all processes in which the RNA is involved. So it is considered that this is the question and this is the answer is now coming, and this is the question for your board exam also, that prove that which is the first genetic material. So it was been concluded that RNA is the first genetic material. Why do? Point number one, that RNA is involved in many of the processes, life processes, like in various metabolism and translation. Here I am giving just the definition of translation, however it will come in detail in the next, after 2-3 pages. Translation is actually the process by which the information coded on RNA is transcribed in the form of, translated in the form of protein. Actually, the DNA has the information for the synthesis of protein, but DNA cannot come out of the nucleus, so it transfers its information on RNA, that is called as transcription. And after, when the RNA information is, when the information is coded on RNA, that RNA comes out through the nucleopore and then it translates its information brought from the DNA in the form of protein. This process is called as translation. If it is not, you are not getting this point here, no problem, you just learn the name and this will come again in detail after 2-3 pages. And then it comes the splicing. Splicing is again a complete process. It is also coming after 2-3 pages. Splicing is the process of cutting the undesired part of the DNA, in which also the help of RNA is required. So this here I have just given you the small knowledge of, very little knowledge of these two terms. They are as coming in the detail afterwards. Now here coming what? So that it is, it is been proved that RNA has evolved first. After that, RNA used to act as a genetic material as well as catalyst also. It was been discussed earlier also that because of 2-OH group, RNA is more reactive and it acts as a catalyst. Actually, the enzymes act as catalyst, biocatalyst, but in some of the processes, the enzymes are not involved, protein enzymes are not involved, but some of the metabolism or processes, biochemical reactions are catalyzed by RNA catalyst. So this is the second point which proves that RNA is a very important biomolecule. And next is RNA being a catalyst is very reactive. This also we have seen earlier. It is very reactive and it is unstable also. It is single stranded. Okay. So it has arisen during the course of evolution. It has arisen the demand of a stable molecule. So that a stable molecule is formed, that is DNA, from the RNA with some chemical modification. That means RNA has little bit modified and it has become stable molecule like the DNA, because RNA is single stranded but DNA is double stranded, and it has its two complementary chains or two helix are there, as it is shown here that DNA has its two helix, which is so that it is called as double helical, but RNA is single helical. Is that clear? So this is about the RNA world, in which you are to convert it into the point that RNA is involved in various metabolism, translation and splicing. Number two, RNA act as a catalyst and it catalyzed various biochemical reaction. And third is very much reactive and unstable, so that it was a need of a very stable molecule with some chemical modification. The RNA has now further changes into the DNA and register the changes of evolving a process of repair. That means DNA register some changes, is little bit mutate, but mutation is not faster in the DNA, so the change, it register the changes, it is called as. Okay, thank you.